Hey friends, have you ever wondered what's going on under the hood for serverless offerings like Azure Container Instances? MacKenzie Olson is here to show me the latest innovations in the infrastructure that powers ACI today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with MacKenzie Olson. How are you?
I'm doing well, Scott. How about yourself?
I am living the remote dream. But I'm excited to talk to you about ACI because you're going to tell me what's going on underneath. Because from my point of view, I just spin up containers willy-nilly and they do their jobs and then they go away. But I don't really know how it's happening.
Yeah, I'm excited to talk to you a little bit about what's going on under the hood here. So as you said, ACI is a serverless offering, but that doesn't mean we don't have lots of servers and VMs busy in the background working away. So today, I'd like to peel back the covers a little bit and talk about what's going on in the ACI architecture.
Okay, so you've got a slide here.
Absolutely. So here we have a rough outline of what our backend infrastructure looks like. So this is what's happening when you're deploying a container group via ACI. Here, it lands basically through our control plane onto a set of service fabric clusters. We're able to support containers at a really large scale in a hostile multi-tenant secure way. We also have been working really hard on the unifying the efforts between our Windows and Linux container story, and I'm going to peel back the covers a little bit about how we're able to do that as well.
When you say hostile and multi-tenant, that sounds not only totally awesome, but also something that I should probably ask about. Does that mean that you like trust no one and any container next to you could be evil?
That's basically the premise of, yeah, hostile multi-tenancy. There's a little bit we should probably cover in terms of container isolation modes.
Okay.
So there are two main ways that you can isolate a container. One is through process isolation, and this is where all containers are sharing the same kernel. You can still provide isolation through namespacing and whatnot, but as you're alluding to earlier, if a bad actor escapes from the container or gets access to the host otherwise, all containers that are running on that host are essentially vulnerable to that attack. On the flip side, there's also Hyper-V isolation. This is where each container is getting their own isolated kernel, which is going to give you essentially VM-level isolation and provides a much more secure environment for your container.
Okay, but that's not like big, scary 30 gig VM like when I start up a virtual machine on my local machine, right?
No, you still get the performance benefits of standard containers. You're just getting that extra level of security from within.
Sweet.
On our ACI infrastructure, we are only supporting Hyper-V isolated containers, which means you can rest assured that your container is isolated from any other workloads, including other container groups that you're deploying as well.
Ah, okay. So this slide that we're looking at right here is saying that these are kinds of container isolation modes that exist in the world, but not necessarily ones that exist on ACI, because ACI is only Hyper-V?
Exactly. You're only getting Hyper-V containers.
Which is a good thing, because it's the safest one.
Exactly. And there's nothing you have to do to your container. It will accept the same containers that you're running locally via Docker. It's just all how we handle it on our ACI infrastructure.
Sounds awesome.
Yeah. And so now that we've kind of covered the difference between our process isolated and Hyper-V isolated containers, I wanted to do a zoom in on an ACI data plane VM or node, if you're familiar with Kubernetes jargon.
Okay.
So you can see we have our ACI infra VM, and we have two different customers with containers on here, tenant A and tenant B. And you might notice via looking at the logos, we have a Linux container running for tenant A and a Windows container running for tenant B, all on within the same Windows VM. So we're actually able to achieve this by using a really cool container runtime, a fork of it called Containerd. Are you familiar with that at all, Scott?
I am not, but I would like to be familiar with that.
Yeah. Containerd essentially is really cool because it's abstracting away the underlying host in the sense that you can run any operating system on top. It's driving the run C binary. And because of that, we're actually able to run our Linux and Windows containers on our Windows host. And basically provide the exact same experience and pack them onto the same VMs.
Okay, that's pretty sweet. And then a reminder just to myself and the folks that listen that Azure is running on Windows. Like, that's the thing that's always so cool to be reminded of. Even though these are tiny little lightweight VMs and they run really fast, the ACI, you call it the infra VM, that's Windows, because Azure is a big giant Windows world computer.
Exactly. It's really cool that we're able to light up both our Linux and Windows containers on those Windows hosts, leveraging the work with Containerd.
What's going on with these cows and wows in the corner here?
Yeah, so if you want to get up to date with the acronyms here, so LCOW stands for Linux Containers on Windows. So the container on the left there is an example of that. Windows Containers on Windows host is WCOW, and we refer to our ACI infrastructure as accepting StarCOW. So if you're familiar with regex, that's either Linux or Windows Containers on Windows.
That's awesome. I look forward to the StarCOW mascot that is sure to pop out of the show.
I definitely did a double take the first time I heard that acronym as well.
Okay, cool.
So how does this really impact you as an ACI customer? We'll take a little bit of a peek at the roadmap for the ACI product. So because of our ability to accept StarCOW containers, we're going to be having a much more robust Windows container story on ACI in 2021. We're actually skipping a little bit ahead, looking for virtual network support for our Windows containers, which we're really excited to announce. We're also going to have support for NSF file share mounts for our Linux containers. And the most recent coming up release is going to be our GA of our managed identity integration.
And that managed identity, so that means the way that Azure does identity and the way that we like go somewhere and it auto goes into Azure AD and all that kind of stuff. You're saying ACI will know about that natively?
So we know about it today in a preview capacity, but we have a couple limitations, specifically that you're not able to run your managed identity enabled container group in a virtual network. And with the GA, we're actually going to be able to offer both of those features in conjunction, which we're really excited about.
Cool. Congratulations. That's cool. And then virtual network support is going to be really exciting. And then you pointed out there early 2021 NFS file shares, which is going to be great for our Linux friends.
Exactly. Yeah, we're excited to support a different type of file share mount for our Linux container groups.
Okay. So slides are fun, but demos are more fun.
Yes, I'm excited to show you this GA of managed identity in action. All right. So this is my resource group up in Azure. I have a couple of things going on here. So I have a container group that's already up and running. It's deployed inside of my virtual network. I have a subnet delegated for my worker container. I also have a subnet for my app gateway, which is going to be accepting traffic, and a storage count as well, where I'm going to be pulling data for my container to process. I also have a key vault set up because I would like to keep my storage account credentials within there, and I've deployed my container group to be attached to a user-assigned managed identity, and that's how I'm going to be accessing the storage blob endpoint. So we'll pop into this container. We can see it's up and running. We have a Linux container here. And if we were to check in on the properties, you can see it's deployed inside my virtual network, inside of the ACI subnet that I've delegated to it.
Is it concerning that it has a 00 private IP address?
No, that's just because I didn't assign it a specific IP on my subnet. And I didn't expose a port. Mm-hmm. And so this is another cool functionality. If you haven't used ACI on the portal before, we actually allow you to exec into your container using this little tool. You can also do this via the AZ CLI as well.
So you're like SSHing into that right now?
Exactly.
I like to say shushing.
All right, and now we are inside of our container. And the first thing I'm going to do is curl Azure Active Directory to get my access token to my key vault, which is connected to my managed identity. Otherwise, we won't be able to gain access. All right, and I've stored that as a variable, and I'm going to curl in my key vault. I have stored both my storage endpoint and the password, but we'll just be curling the endpoint.
So that 169 endpoint, that's a known management infrastructure endpoint, right?
Yes, there are a couple different ways that you can access AAD. You can do it via curl, you can do it programmatically. For the sake of showing you live today, we've decided to just curl that known endpoint.
I just think it was always, I think that's a thing, like a little Azure thing that like some people love and know about and some people just don't know about. Like there's an IP address that through the power of software-defined networking, it's always got great information and you can just, without even being authenticated, because you're in Azure, get information about yourself and your friends and the other things that are happening.
Exactly. And you can see now that we've received that token from that endpoint, we can get the name of our storage blob. And with that, I'm able to securely connect to it, run whatever I need within the storage blob, all in a secure way where I haven't, you know, put in the credentials within the container that someone else could access. It's a user assigned identity. So if this container restarts for whatever reason, the identity is preserved beyond the life cycle of the container, which is pretty cool. And again, it's all running in my virtual network. So it's secure and not publicly exposed to the internet unless I decide to connect it up to my application gateway.
Very cool.
Yeah. And so we're excited. This is still in a preview capacity, and we're excited to release this into GA this upcoming November.
Very cool. So where can people learn more about that?
So you can go ahead and look up our ACI documentation. We'll have it hyperlinked to this video, and there is a tutorial that can get you up and running with managed identities. And look forward to the GA experience this upcoming November, where we'll have integration with other features like Azure Virtual Network as well.
Fantastic. I am learning all about ACI and what's happening under the hood today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.